Hi, gang. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me today. Today is April 3rd, 2022, and early this morning at 2:51 a.m. local time, there was a magnitude 3.6 earthquake there along the Walker Lane Fault Zone, 16 kilometers northeast of Barstow, California. 24 people have reportedly felt this earthquake. Using Google Earth, here's the location of that earthquake, and I'll bring it out, drawn out in a light blue color. I have the Walker Lane Fault Zone. This is not far from the Garlock Fault Zone. Anywhere within this area, there is a chance of having a magnitude 7.0 earthquake, maybe a slightly larger. Back in 2019, you'll know what we started to have all those earthquakes there in Ridgecrest. The Garlock Fault Zone has never had a history of any major earthquakes. A lot of people probably find that quite fascinating. But it goes down here into the San Andreas Fault Zone, which has increased the likelihood of a large earthquake because of the pressure that's being built in this locked zone of the Garlock and San Andreas Fault Zone has increased. There hasn't been a large earthquake along the San Andreas Fault Zone in about 165 years. So here is one of the monitors, the data that I downloaded. They didn't fudge about the earthquake. It was actually a magnitude 3.63. Probably closer to a 3.6. And we'll look at the spectrogram right there. And this comes from, let's see, the monitor there at Barstow. There's the earthquake. This one is Barstow, and this one here is Hector. Going back to Google Earth, here's the monitor for Barstow. There's the location of the earthquake, about 10 miles south of the earthquake's location. Most of the felt reports came in from Barstow so far, which is down here where that earthquake station is at. Yeah, I'm sure a lot more people felt this earthquake, but being so early in the morning, I doubt if they even probably even thought about reporting it. Afterwards, there was a magnitude 1.6 at 3:22 a.m. Here's the location of that earthquake. Let me bring it out and show you in relation to the 3.6. And again, this is the Walker Lane Fault Zone. These are the only two earthquakes that USGS has reported for this location in the last 30 days. Going back to the swarm program, here is that small earthquake, the 1.6. I believe it was actually larger. Let me bring it down for you so you can see this. 1.63, because if you look at the seismic signature, how much I shortened it up, I would have probably put it more likely at a 1.86. And I'll show you there at the bottom. There was probably two more that they are not reporting. That would be that one right there. Let me bring it up for you. At 13:15, and another one. Oh, where is it? 13:43. Let's check out this one here. 14:14. These are really tiny. But this one they're not reporting. It's actually probably two different earthquakes. Let me go back to the signature. Yeah, tiny. If I put it in as one earthquake instead of dividing it up into two, I get a magnitude 2.05. Often they'll do that, though. Put it in as two earthquakes instead of one. Let me go up to the spectrogram when they kind of, you can see it just, it was probably an earthquake along with a, what they call a tremor, a long vibration of that earthquake. Yeah, and let's make this bigger. That is more than likely a mixture of both tectonic earthquakes, which is the movement of the plate, and volcanic. And you know that there is volcanic activity. They got the hydrothermal plants going on up over here by the Coso volcanic fields. I have drawn out here the direction of the Walker Lane fault zone. It's actually over 100 miles wide. I got it drawn out in blue, the different block sections. And then down over here, I have drawn out the direction of the Garlock fault zone. And then I also have drawn out, going down over here to this blocked section. It's an S bend for the San Andreas fault zone. So we got the Garlock up here, and then the direction of the San Andreas fault zone. Also today, near Ludlow, there was a magnitude 1.6. And then they got a new one here, up here for Ridgecrest, a magnitude 1.4 at 10:49. These are all the earthquakes within the last 30 days. And like I said, all these earthquakes that are occurring within the Walker Lane seismic zone are increasing the pressure on the Garlock fault zone. So I added in the USGS hazards map. Yeah, not good. Look at all that. Let's bring it out a little bit. Anyways, here's the 3.6. This here is the 1.6. Over here is Ridgecrest. And we'll bring it out a bit. Let me pull this over for you. So did you feel this earthquake? If so, please put those comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please thumbs up my videos. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.